Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students, welcome to second PUC Accountancy Online Classes. In the previous class we have solved problem number 9. Only one problem is remaining in your question bank, that is page number 65, problem number 10. Let us solve this problem now. I will read out the problem and in the meantime we will analyze and we will solve the problem. Girish, Mahesh and Varun were sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 6:3:2 respectively. Their capitals on 1st April 2017 stood at rupees 60,000, rupees 30,000 and rupees 20,000 respectively. On 30th September 2017, Varun died. Varun expired. The goodwill of the deceased partner's share is rupees 10,000. See, straight away his share of goodwill is given. So, no work for us. Simply we will credit, isn't it? By debiting continuing partner's capital account. Then, deceased partner's share in accrued profit up to the date of his death is rupees 4,200. This is also very clear. Up to the date of death, whatever profit should be given to the deceased partner is clearly his share is given. So, no need of any calculation here. Varun's commission is rupees 600 per month. Varun expired on which date? Varun died on 30th September. Year started on 1st April. Remember, not April, that is January, December concept. This is April, March concept. So, April to September means April, May, June, July, August, September. 6 months. Correct. So, half year. So, 6 months you have to calculate per month 600. So, 600 into 6. That's all. His drawings up to the date of death amounted to rupees 8,000. So, enter on the debit side. Interest on capital at 10% per annum. Only for 6 months you have to calculate. As we have already calculated in almost all the problems, isn't it? That's all. Prepare capital account of Varun. Let us prepare capital account. No working note is required. Varun's capital account. Varun's capital account. Capital account. Yes. Write debit credit, draw the columns, particulars, JF, amount in rupees on either side. We can do it fast. As it is capital account, we will start with what? By balance brought down. Correct. By balance brought down. Write Varun's capital. Varun's capital, how much it is? Varun's capital is 20,000, correct. So, credit 20,000. Then, profit and loss suspense account, clearly given how much his share is given, right? Profit and loss, if such problem comes, luck of the students, isn't it? But I don't know whether you will enter the same amount or you will try to bifurcate it again into 6/12 or something like that, you will do and you will do a mistake. Actually, answer is given, but sometimes students will get confused, isn't it? So, try to understand the sentence given very clearly. So, profit and loss suspense account, current year profit, isn't it? How much? Suspense account 4,000. 4,000 given in the problem, no need to calculate. Then, what else? Commission, by commission account, 600 per month for 6 months, so 3,600, am I correct? 3,600. Then, interest on capital, that is capital amount was 20,000 into what is the rate of interest given in the problem? that is 10%, right? Yes, 10%, 10 by 100 into 6 by 12, only for 6 months. So, how much it will be? 1000, is that correct? 1000. Then, goodwill treatment should be given. Goodwill treatment, how much they should bear? Those continuing partners, Girish and Mahesh, am I correct? So, by Girish's capital account, Girish's capital account and Mahesh's capital account. Mahesh's capital account. Girish's capital account is how much? Yes, what is the ratio? 6:3. Correct. So that itself will be the gain ratio. 6:3 means 6 by 9 and 3 by 9. So 6 by 9 and 3 by 9 into the amount of goodwill. How much it is? Amount of goodwill given in the problem. Share in deceased partner share is goodwill of the firm. Yes, goodwill of the deceased partner share is 10,000, right? 10,000. Now find out how much it is and write in outer column, that is 6,667 and 3,333. That's all. All the entries being done. Yes. Now take the total. Write the total. Write the same total on the other side. You will get 38,800. 38,800. Here also 38,800. Find out the difference. There is no debit entry, right? Is there any debit entry? Yes, there is a debit entry. We have paid amount of rupees. That is his drawings up to the date of death. Amount is rupees 8,000. We are preparing capital account. So, to bank account. To bank account. Drawings. This is not amount paid. This is drawings made by the partner. Isn't it? Drawings 8,000. 8,000. Now find out the difference and transfer it to, we are preparing capital account, so executor's account, you have to transfer, correct. So 30,800 to Varun's executor's account. Varun's executor's account. Transferred balancing figure. Yes, your problem is solved, wasn't it? Very simple problem. Such problem if appears, then within 4 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes, you can solve the problem. 6 marks easily you will get. You can save your time. Correct. Yes. With this, friends, your death of a partner chapter comes to an end. Now, one small part is there. That is one practical oriented question is there. It was given in your question bank also. Prepare executor's loan account with imaginary figures showing the repayment in 2 annual equal installments along with interest. So we have to prepare executor's loan account. We have to assume that amount is returned to the executors in 2 equal annual installments along with interest we have to pay. That means date column is a must. Date column must be there. Otherwise, it is not possible to pay the interest or credit the interest or make the installment payment, isn't it? So let us prepare it. Write practical oriented question. Prepare executor's loan account with imaginary figures. Remember, friends, whenever imaginary figures they asked, you must assign figures. If you put XXX, we will put X and 0. Remember, we will add 0 there along with X. So, don't write XXX in the figure column. Whenever they told with imaginary figures, write the figures. Don't put XXX. Clear. Not only here, anywhere in the format, some formats they may ask in financial statements, maybe balanced format, They may ask you to put the figure, then put the figure. If nothing is mentioned, you are free to put X also. You are free to write figures also. Clear? Yes. Now, while preparing executor's loan account, you should make sure that you will write the name of the partner first. Whose executor's loan account? Is it mine? Is it yours? Isn't it? Question comes. So, X's executor's loan account. Executor's loan account. Executor's loan account. Now, draw the columns like this. First, there should be date column. Date, then particulars, provide for JF, then amount column, again date, particulars, JF, amount in rupees. Debit credit is a must. Debit credit. Date, write the column headings, particulars. Most of the times they ask this problem in the board exam. Practical unit question. JF, amount in rupees. Some students confuses with the date column. They avoid date column and no marks will be awarded for that. Remember. Date, particulars, JF, amount in rupees, amount in rupees. Yes. Now let us start. See, whenever we start, remember, when you prepare executor's account, you transfer the final balance to which account? Executor's account is supposed prepared. Varun's executor's account. Then final balance will be transferred to Varun's executor's loan account. Am I correct? So here, let us assume X is there. X's executor's account we have prepared. Final balance you will transfer it to X's executor's loan account, right? So X's executor's loan account gets opened here. Journal entry is X's executor's account debtor to X's executor's loan account. But here you just start with by X's executors or X's capital account. You can start with X's capital account also. By X's capital account. Any date you can assign. They told the total amount should be paid in equal annual installments along with interest. So you have to give in two installments along with interest. But the amount of principal amount should be equal. So take 20,000 as the amount. Don't go for 1 lakh, 1 crore. May get confused later. You may forget to put 1 zero or you may add 1 more zero. Isn't it? Extra zero. And we will add 1 more zero there. So that will happen. Isn't it? While avoiding the marks. Yes. So take 20,000 as the capital balance. So 20,000 is the amount payable, principal amount payable. So if we divide it into two equal annual installments, it will be of 10,000 each. Am I correct? Yes. So start with 1st April 2000, any year for that matter, 2017, April 1st. Clear. Starting of the year. So see the journal entry, don't get confused, don't write on the debit side. Don't write 2X's capital account, gone. So this account will show because loan always appears on the liability side. Am I correct? Loan always appears on the liability side. So is a liability. Liability always shows credit balance, I told you. So it must show credit balance. Very simple. Don't get confused. Yes, done. When the year ends, when the year starts on 1st April 2017, year ends on 31st March 2018, correct? So on 31st March 2018, year started on 1st April 17, ends on 31st March 2017. Remember, you have to credit interest by interest account. Take simple interest. What is the amount payable? 20,000, isn't it? On that, 10% for full year, how much it will come? 2,000. Is that correct? Yes. 2,000 rupees interest you have credited. Remember, interest is always credited on the closing day of the accounting year. After 1 year, you will get the interest. I will give you one analogy. You will keep 10,000 in your bank account today. Whether they will give you interest today itself, whatever interest that is supposed to be paid, you have deposited it for 1 year. Assume whether they will get give you the interest today itself. Okay, your deposit I have received, take interest of 1 year. Whether they will give? No, they will give you only after using that fund. After 1 year, they will pay the interest. They will use that fund, your fund, for 1 year for advancing loan or whatever it is, isn't it? Then after 1 year, they will pay you the interest. So simple logic. So 2,000 interest is credited by the end of the year. So make sure of the date. If you miss the date, gone. Marks will be deducted. So that's all. Now you have to make payment for the first year. What is the installment amount? This 20,000 should be paid in two equal annual installments, 10,000 each. Am I correct? Along with interest. This is the interest. So you will pay on the last day of the accounting year. After 1 year, you will pay. That will be on March 31st, 2018. 2018, March 31st, right? You will write to bank account. First installment paid. First installment paid. How much it is? 10,000 principal amount plus 2,000 interest you are paying now. Are you getting me? 10,000, that is one installment out of this. We have to make it two equal annual installments. So 10,000 plus interest 2,000. 12,000 we have to pay. Now, close this, 22,000, right here, difference 10,000. That will be on the closing date, same date, 31st March 2018, right? To balance carried down, balancing figure it is, balance carried down. Balancing figure. What should the next date? That will be 2018, friends. Most of the times the students, they will miss here, they will write 2019 year. From March to April, your year will not change. See the calendar. Very simple. Imagine the calendar, keep in your mind. After March 31st, April 1st comes, year will not change. Year remains as it is, no change. Am I correct? But students, they will get confused in the examination and they will write after 31st March 2018, they will write 2019 April 1st. 1 year is left and you will lose marks. So be careful. 2018 April 1st. April 1st by balance brought down. How much? 10,000, right? Now you have 10,000 at the beginning of the year. You are investing this amount. Now, after 1 year, when it comes 2019, March 31st, you will get the interest by interest account. Interest on loan account, it is. How much? You have 10,000 amount at the beginning. So at the rate of 10%, it will be 1,000. Is that correct? Now, second year is closed. 11,000 is the total. write the same total on the other side. Now you have to make payment of second installment. So that will be on the closing date 2019 March 31st. Am I correct? To bank account, second installment paid. Second installment paid. That is 10,000 principal amount. See the amount here. First year also we paid 10,000. Second year also we paid 10,000. So the entire amount is settled. Am I correct? In two equal annual installments. Plus along with interest. See there, interest 1,000. So 11,000 we will pay now. Is there any balance now? Loan is settled with interest. Clear? That is what we have to prepare. For this you will get 5 marks. Most of the times in question paper you can see this question. Every time they ask this question, so make sure of it. Don't forget to write the dates. Very simple. Here also, here only beginning date, all end date. Here also beginning date, then all end date. That's all. So 11,000 here you have paid the entire amount is settled, so there is no balance in loan account. So, and this is not mandatory. You need not take 20,000 only. You can take 10,000 also. You can take 1 lakh also. You can take 1 crore also. Makes no difference. But answer should be correct. It should be perfect. And again, interest on that is capital. I took 10% just to make it easy. You can take 5%. You can take 8% or 8.5%. No problem. But while calculating, don't do mistakes. So go in a simple way. Clear? Yes. Take assignment. Solve this practical oriented question and submit. Practical oriented question, solve and submit on time. Thank you for watching this video.